So welcome to the Oracle Primera Project Management webinar. So here, let's have a look on the Primera concepts and features. So this is enterprise project management. So here we have enterprise-wide planning and control solution, which enables you to stay within the budget and meet deadlines by effectively managing your scheduled resources and costs. So in Primera, the projects are stored in a centralized database and we can access it using the client server technology and the web also. So the benefits of enterprise project management is it enables your organization to manage demands based on the stakeholder needs and assign priority to the project. So this process has been accepted by the stakeholders in that organization. So when prioritizing the project, it takes up all the assessment criteria into consideration. So it prevents your duplication of projects and resources also. So it has the integrated framework, which permits the performance monitoring of the projects throughout the project level and the portfolio level also. So next is we have the capabilities of enterprise portfolio project management. It has the planning and scheduling, so team collaboration and workflow among your projects. So we can do better decisions based on the project resource and cost information management. So P6 can able to handle large scale and multifaceted projects. So it is capable of handling 1 lakh of activities. So it will deliver your programs, projects on the time and within the budget. So it is having centralized resource management where resources are stored in a centralized location. So along with our project planning and management, we have risk management, threshold management, and issue management. So the tracking feature is enabled along with your projects. You can track your programs also. So the versions available in Primera Project Management is here you have P6 Professional for Enterprise Portfolio Project Management. This is a web application and the main interface for all the project management functionality. And then here you have P6 Professional. This is the desktop version for doing your project management and portfolio management. So along with that, you have the progress reporter. So this is the timesheet where you can where your team members can record their working hours and send it to their project manager for approval. So and Primera P6 Visualizer. So this is integrated along with the P6 Professional. So here you can create, modify, and manage your timescale logic diagrams and Gantt charts too. So this P6 Analytics is mainly used for reporting tool, which includes dashboard features also. So this Primera project management is having basic concepts such as enterprise project structure and organization basics, return structure. So first we'll see about enterprise project structure. It is a hierarchy used to organize your projects. So it will roll up and summarize your data across the projects and we can view resource allocation across your project. So you can create an enterprise structure and you can create projects within that each elements. So next is we'll be having this organizational breakdown structure. So this organization breakdown structure is hierarchy of the resources working in your organization. It is from the top level to the project level. You can view it here. So this is the basic structure of Primera project management. So within each enterprise project structure, you'll be having various elements, EPS elements. So within each EPS elements, you have different projects. And within the projects, you'll be having the activities, WBS and risk documents, issues, etc. So this OBS, organizational breakdown structure, will be assigned to the EPS and also to all the levels in your Primera. So even you can assign it to the projects, activities, work breakdown structure, and risk everything. So this OBS is the main thing. We can create users and give the security and permissions to access the Primera. So based on the OBS, we can create users and give the permissions to access the Primera to them. So based on the structure, there are two types of data in Primavera. You have enterprise data and project data. So enterprise data, you have this global structure. So where whatever data is included in the enterprise, all the projects will be able to access this enterprise data. So here you have this examples like enterprise project structure, project code, resource code, and resources cost account. So all these data is in a centralized location where all your projects can access these datas. But you have this project data here. You have all the data related only to the specific project. So wherein you can able to create for each and every project. So you can create work breakdown structure, activities, your expenses, risk. So all these data you have to create for each and every project. So this is the project specific data. So these are the advanced features related to Primavera Enterprise Project Portfolio Management. So here you have the topics here. So now we'll move on to the demo of Project Primavera Management.
Yes, we can see the screen.
Okay. So this is the Primavera project management window. So this is your default project window. So here your projects are organized in an enterprise project structure. So you have to first create your enterprise project structure according to your organizational requirement here. And then you have to create your organizational breakdown structure here. So based on the organization resources, you can create your organizational breakdown structure here. So after this, you'll be having this type of structure in your project window. So where in each EPS element, you can see the project listed here. So you can create any number of projects within the EPS nodes and elements. So this is the project details window where you have all the related project informations here. Your project ID, name, and dates, project start date, and if there is any finish date, you can give it here. And if there is any calendar you have to assign it to your project, you can assign it here. So all the general details will be providing it in the project details window. So after this, you'll be opening the projects. So here you'll be having your activities window. So here you'll have your activities listed and then the Gantt chart. So this is the visual representation of your activities here. So here you can create any number of activities with the duration and the logical relationships. So after, so for example, if I am creating some activities, so you can change your duration here. And if you want to link it with other activities, you can link. So like this, you have to create your activities, duration, and your logical relationship, and then you have to go for tools schedule. So this schedule will, Primavera will automatically schedule your project, and it will automatically create your critical activities and non-critical activities and the critical path method too. So here you can use this log file where automatically your schedule reports are provided in this particular file. You can find it in your system. In this path. So when you schedule, the Primavera will automatically schedule your activities and give you a schedule. So other than this, this is the schedule view, and here you'll be having this network diagram view. Here you'll be having the activities represented as nodes and the relationship between your activities. So here you'll be having the trace logic view. So wherein the connections can be seen easily regarding your activities. So this is the activity details window. So you have to provide all the activity details here. Suppose if you want to assign any particular calendar for only one activity, you can provide it here. So this is the scheduling part. So after a tool schedule, you'll be getting the total duration of the project, your start date and finish date. So it will also give you the total float, which defines the critical activities in your project. So next we'll be going for the WBS. So basically you can create, this is the default structure, you can create only the activities. So after this you will be having this project WBS, so wherein you can create your work breakdown structures here. So what are the levels in your projects? So these are my levels in my project. So here you can create any number of levels. So you can use this indent and outer arrows to structure your WBS. And then after creating this work breakdown structure, you come to the activity. Here you can assign your work breakdown structure. So for each and every activity, in which particular WBS element it is coming, you can assign it directly. So after assigning this, you can go for a group and sort, you can select your WBS, and then you can see your work breakdown structure related to your project. So within each work breakdown element, you can see your activities. So this is the work breakdown structure. So this is the scheduling, the scheduling projects. So next we'll be going for the resources. Here, resources is stored in a centralized location. So all the resources will be accessed throughout the projects in your organization. So if you create any resource also, it can be accessed by all the projects. So here you can create resource like this. So here in the resource details window, can provide all the informations here, your resource ID, name, and here you have resource types. Three types are there: labor, non-labor, and material. Labor is manpower resources, non-labor is machinery resources, and for the material, you can select which unit of measure you're going to use for the particular material. So if you want to create and assign any particular calendar for this particular resource, you can do it here. And then you can provide the maximum available working time for the resource, and then the working rate for the project, for the resource. So here you have roles. So Primora is having a feature of roles. So suppose if your organization doesn't have a particular resource like a construction engineer or a project engineer, so you doesn't have a particular resource, you can create a role like this. You can create a role. Like this, and you can wait for the organization to recruit the resources. After recruiting the resources, you can assign from this window. So here you can assign this particular resource as your construction engineer. So we can do both. We can create roles and assign resources, or also if you create resources and then you can assign your roles here. So both vice versa, you can do it here. So this is regarding your roles and resources. So you can create any number of resources and roles here. And then moving on to the activity. So here you have to assign resources to your activities. So for each activity, you can come to the activity details window. So in resource tab, you can able to see the add resource button. So this will display all your resources in the organization. So whichever resources you want, you can able to assign it here. So how many hours or day the particular resource is working in your project, you can provide it here. So after defining this, you'll be getting the total cost of your project. So this is the this is regarding the resources assigning. So after assigning your resources, you'll be having this resource usage profile. So resource usage profile will show you the what is the maximum availability of resources you have and whether it is over allocated or not. So in graphical format, you can able to see these resources. So you have this resource usage spreadsheet. So wherein the same information, you can view it in a spreadsheet format. So in Primavera, we have two types of data. One is project data and other is enterprise data. So first we'll see about the project data. So in project data, along with the activities and WBS, you have this expenses. So in expenses, suppose expenses is extra cost or add-on cost to your projects. So if you want to assign any expenses to your particular activity, so limit your expense like this. So you can provide your expense details here. So the expense may be your transport expenses, travel expenses, setup cost, your administration cost. So all this will come under the expenses. So here you'll be having this cost related details where you have provide the budgeted cost of your expenses. So after this, we have work products and documents. Suppose if you want to assign any document to your activity, you can do it here. So you can add any document related to your project, any RFQ or contractor agreement or any travel document. So anything you can assign it here. So here you can assign your file from the system. And then you can assign it to your any activity. So you can able to provide the description here. So this is the work products and documents. And then you have risk. So while planning the project itself, we can able to identify the risk in our project. So those risks we can able to enter it here. Suppose you have any risk related to your project, you can create it here and you can provide all the details in the risk detail window. So here you can have the risk owner, who's the owner of your risk and what is the impact it is going to provide and which activity it is we are going to assign and the description, causes, effects. So everything you can define it here. So in impact, we can also able to give the pre-response and post-response. So what is the probability that it is going to occur in your particular project and what is the probability it is going to affect your schedule, cost. So all the information you can give it here and what is the response type and the response description also you can provide it here. So you can able to list out all the risk available in your project here. So similarly, you can also able to list out the risk issues and thresholds in your projects. So the same way you can able to do for the issues and thresholds. So next we'll be having this enterprise data. So enterprise data, already we have seen about resources and roles. So those are our enterprise data. So here we'll be having this activity codes. So here we'll be having this activity code. So activity code is organizing your activities based on the user defined attribute. Suppose if I want to organize my activity based on the priority or on the budget, you can define it here. So here you can add any number of activity codes. So here you can able to add any activity codes, like if you like a budget structure, you can add it here and you can provide the values there. So after adding your activity codes, you'll be moving on to the activity window. So here you have a codes tab in the activity window, details window. So there you have to assign activity code to your activities. So here you'll be having this high, medium or low. So for each and every activity, you can select what type of priority it is having. So after this assignment, you will be going for the grouping and sorting. So here you can able to view what are the high priority activities, medium priority activities, and the low priority activities in your project. So based on our requirement, we can able to create the activity codes and assign it to the activities, and you can view it in this activity code structure. So the same thing will goes for project code and resource code. So project code is for organizing your projects, and resource code for organizing your resources. So this is the planning and scheduling of your project. So next we'll be moving on to the tracking part. So next we'll be moving on to the tracking part. So before tracking the project, we have to save the project. We have to save the project plan as your baseline. So after saving the project baseline, we'll be tracking the project. So here we can use this progress spotlight. So it will highlight what are the activities to be updated. So you can select a particular date here. So up to which date you have to update your project. So I'm selecting 25th August. So select your activity and then go for the status tab, and then you can able to provide all the related information here, whether it is started or finished, and what is the percentage of completion. If there is delay in the start, you can also provide it here. And if you want to give the percentage of completion, so all the execute actual data, so you have to provide it here. So next we'll be going on the tools schedule. Here you'll be selecting your date as the schedule. So after this, you can able to see the results in your Gantt chart. So here you can able to see the results in your Gantt chart. So based on this tracking feature, based on this tracking feature, you have this earned value analysis. So this earned value analysis will have metrics, so which will show the project performances of your project. So here you have this schedule variance, cost variance, and budget completion, estimated completion, and variance and completion. So all these data are used to analyze your project performance based on the status you have executed now. So after this, the tracking feature is also enabled for the program level. So when you go for enterprise tracking, so here when you select a particular EPS level, you can able to view what are the projects available here, and you can able to view what is the planned start and finish of the particular project, whether it is started or not, and percentage of completion. And in the bottom, you can able to see the cost related information in the histograms. So you can able to view customize these views, and you can use it efficiently. So this is tracking your projects and as well as tracking your programs also. So next we'll be moving for the reports. So here in Primora, we'll be having all the templates in here. So simply we can select a report, I can directly run the report. So you'll be having the report like this. So whichever report you want, you can directly run the report to your printer. So based on the requirement, you can able to customize these reports based on the templates provided here. So after the reports, we have this visualizer. The visualizer is also included in Primavera. So visualizer is have three parts here. One is Gantt, time scale logic diagram and schedule comparison. So first we'll see about the Gantt. Suppose here you have to select your project. Name it. So here you can able to view the Gantt chart of your project activities. So here you'll be having your activities and the Gantt chart without the logical relationship in a time scaled format. So you can use this options to customize your Gantt chart, and then you can directly print this layout. So next you'll be having this time scale logic diagram. So here also you have to select a particular project. Name it. And then here you'll be having only the bars, activity bars in your layout. So here also you can have this customization option. So you can able to customize according to your requirement, and then you can draw it. So here we'll be having only the bars, not the activities list. And then we have this schedule comparison report. So here so you can name it. So you can select two projects to compare. Two projects, or you can compare your baselines also here. Project with your baseline. So any number or any project you can select here, and then you can go for. Go to add, and then you'll be having this save and draw. So here it will provide the differences report according to the project you have selected. So here you'll be having this options. So based on the options, you can able to customize your requirements. So what are the things you need to add in this report? So you can select this, and then you can save and draw. So this is about the visualizer. So these are the features and concepts available in Primavera. So now let's move on to the presentation. So here, this is the Primavera 6 Enterprise Portfolio Project Management view. So this is the view wherein you have your activities at the Gantt chart. And this is your resource allocations view. So this is your portfolio view where you have your projects and the graphical reports regarding your projects. So this is the dashboard view where you have all the project related information in a single page. So this is the portfolio Gantt view along with your Gantt chart. So how your resources are spread across the time scale. So these are the various other reports you have in EPPM version. And this is the risk management window and the other details. So these are our curriculum of Primavera. So based on the features that we have shown now. So CAPPM is doing certain services and solutions here, such as advisory services, professional services, and business agility transformation services, implementation services, and we are also providing training and development services. So along with the services, we have this workshops also. Workshops on certification, PMI certification, SAFE certification, and we have this best practices workshop on PMI and PPM technology. So this is our website. You can use this website to see the details regarding our organization. So thank you for your valuable time for the webinar. So if you have any questions, please let me.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good evening, madam. I have one question for this enterprise portfolio project management.
Okay.
Normally, for this, when we use the Primavera tool, it is easier to manage at an enterprise level, right?
Yes.
Where there is a professionally responsibilities assigned to the employees, but like in the case of where there is a project manager, how can he manage the complete project over this using this tool?
The project manager will be allocated a particular project, so he can able to access only the particular project, and he can able to control the team members. So based on the access and permissions, it is provided there.
Okay. So the project manager does his inputs. He provides his inputs, and the rest project like Primavera or maybe MS project is done by the multiple team members, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Fine.
The team members can access their set of information, and the project manager at the overall level, so he or she can access the high level project information. And team members also can update using the task or the timesheet options, timesheets in a Microsoft project, and progress reporter in Primavera. So either through that they can give the update, and once it's approved, that will be updated in the plan. So the project manager can go ahead and approve, then it can be updated in the project plan.
Fine, sir. Just a small question to that. Normally, when these projects are very tightly scheduled, but very with a strict timelines, in that case, if the complete information is not updated on with one particular tool, maybe Project Primavera or maybe MSP, at that time, how does this tool help actually in this scenario?
No, so that any tool could not help out, because the basic information, so if we are implemented any tool, so that then we need to feed the information, because that type of intelligence is not still added in our products. So it is our responsibility as project managers and team members. We need to give the information, then only we'll be able to analyze. Otherwise, just having it, we could not do it. So that is
no, that's correct. Yeah. But only question is, I think these tools are more versatile when working on a very large scale projects. Is it true?
Not fully true. So that for example, Microsoft project, at any point, any level, you can make use of that for this project. So even for a small project or medium projects, and Primavera mostly it's used in medium and big projects.
Last couple. Okay. Yeah. Thick. Thank you.
Any other questions? We will cross the time. So if you have any questions, we'll take any one final question and then we close. And also we have shared our feedback from the chat. So if you can fill out and submit, so that will be helpful for us.
Sir, we shall be getting the recording of this session.
Yes, we'll be sharing the recording in another 24 to 48 hours once it's ready. So we'll be sharing that.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so if there are no questions, then today. So thank you so much for joining in. So thank you, everyone. Have a nice evening. Yeah. Okay, bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, madam. Have a good evening.
Thank you, sir.